everyone. I am the Play Gamer 3. This is part 19 of my walkthrough of Chronicles of the Sword.
We meet again. Not quite so successful at evading me without that old fool Merlin to hold your hand. Your name is? It slipped my mind. Are you a messenger or an assassin? Well, have you been struck dumb? What have you got to say for yourself?
Let me go and we can just forget about everything that went on between us.
Morgana, I have a message from the king.
Have you ever wondered, knight, why you were sent here to face me? You mean nothing to me. You are just a scrap of life, waiting to be stepped on and snuffed out.
I'm sure Merlin and King Arthur will save me. They will send an army to come rescue me. Oh, who am I kidding? They're not going to come save me.
I am a knight of the greatest court in Albion. I have sworn allegiance to my king and queen, and I am sworn to fight to the death any living thing which threatens their safety.
Tell me what you think of me, knight. Am I not more beautiful than that one foolish creature who makes a fool of my half-brother, Arthur?
Well, you do look like a sexy version of the Wicked Witch of the West, and I hear you give good head, but Lady Guinevere is a crazy sex addict. So I would have to go with her.
You have great beauty, Morgana, but your heart is evil.
Poor fool! You understand nothing. Merlin has been filling your head with false ideas about morality. There is no morality. There is no good or evil. These are purely the ideals of Arthur's new religion. I will not serve. I will serve neither Arthur nor a false divinity, as you can see. I am a much misunderstood woman. Poor Helly. Such a simple creature.
Helly was loyal to you until you betrayed her.
Death comes to you. If I stamp on a cockroach, does that make me evil? If I snuff out an obstacle, does that make me wicked? Arthur has slaughtered whole armies in the furtherance of his ambitions. Does that make Arthur wicked and evil? But tell me, how does it feel to be a cockroach? About to be stamped on.
No. But killing a priest. Killing Helly. Trying to destroy Camelot. That makes you an evil bitch.
You may kill me, but others will come to find me.
Enough of this. You are an assassin sent by Merlin. Now you will die.
You will die also, Morgana.
Goodbye, knight.
Ah!
Ah! It's a pit. It looks bottomless.
There is a key somewhere on the ground. I have to find it.
An old key. This must match a door down here somewhere. This lamp drips tallow everywhere. It is such an oily substance. This tallow should lubricate the key. It's a large lock. Good. The key turns beautifully. Wait! There is a flight of steps. They must lead somewhere.
Thank you.
trees look like the trees in the forest. They have been petrified. This must be the work of Morgana. Sword.
The question is, have you grown weak, or has the sword grown heavy?
another task.
Ragnar is a formidable foe, is he not? Without your sword, he will slice you up and suck the marrow from your bones. What a pity you no longer have the Ring of Protection!
I'm here to kill Morgana. Do your own donkey work.
Now, mortal, don't be like that. Morgana is a powerful sorceress. We must be wary. And you do need your sword.
Very well. What must I do?
You must find us an item, mortal. It is hidden somewhere in Iopes. Morgana's soul. A simple task. Now listen carefully, mortal. It is the size of a man's hand, and it is contained in a vessel which may resemble an urn used for the ashes of cremated humans! While her soul is not in her body, she cannot be harmed. To destroy Morgana, we must find a means of capturing her soul! Hurry, mortal! Hurry! Time is short!
I will return with what you require.
Problems, problems, problems. What now, mortal?
My sword. I can't lift it.
The question is, have you grown weak? Or has the sword grown heavy?
another top.
Ragnar is a formidable.
I'm here to kill.
Now, more.
Very.
You must find. It is the size of a man's hand. While her soul is not in her body.
I will return with what you require. More petrified trees. More petrified trees. Set in stone for eternity. A violation of nature.
Get over it, you tree hugger.
More petrified trees. Set in stone for eternity, a violation of nature. Looks like the branch of a tree. Wait, it's made of stone. It must have been petrified. more petrified trees. Set in stone for eternity. An urn made of human bones. How gruesome. There is something inside it. And if I can just prise the bones apart. There! This is carved from jade. It looks oriental. Something stirs within its depths. It is dark, odd.
This must be Morgana's soul. I would think she would have it better hidden than this.
Of a dragon, a magnificent beast.
It's a dinosaur, not a dragon.
This must be the one I was told of, slain by Morgana. Significant. It is adorned with a large spider. So many nightmares in one space. That door looks significant. It is adorned with a large spider. So many nightmares in one space. I need my sword.
We have an agreement, mortal. The urn in exchange for your sword.
Where is Morgana?
Where is Morgana's soul?
Where must I look for the urn?
We knew mortals were dim, but you are dimmer than most.
fairies. If I obtain the N, how do I know you will not set me another task?
Ah, mortal! Have a little faith, a little trust!
Why ask Gawain? You know he's going to have another task when you give him the urn.
Where is Ragnar?
Ragnar is at his station. And there he will stay until Morgana orders otherwise.
I will return, fairies.
Yes, hopefully with Morgana's soul. What's this? What's this? Yes! Jade, this is it. We have it. Clever one, you have found it for us. We have the soul of the Dark One. Yes! Very good, mortal. Excellent. Ah, see how her soul twists and contorts as if aware that it is in jeopardy. As if seeking to return to Morgana. Now, mortal, we cannot simply break the urn. For if we did, the soul would escape back to Morgana, and she would be at liberty to kill us all! We need two items from Morgana's corporeal self to contrive a spell and bind the soul to the urn so that Morgana cannot, dare not harm us. Firstly, you must bring us one of Morgana's hairs. Bind this, mortal, and return to us quickly!
See, I told you another task. I never left.
Fairies, I need my sword.
We had an agreement, mortal! The hair in exchange for a sword!
No. You said Morgana's soul in exchange for my sword.
Fairies, do not obstruct me. I need my sword! Morgana.
Where is the hair?
How will I obtain a strand of Morgana's hair?
Well, we new mortals were dim, but you are dimmer than most.
If I am so dim, why didn't you find Morgana's soul? You've been here longer than I have.
Fairies, if I obtain the hair, how will I know you will not set me another task?
Ah, mortal! Have a little faith, a little trust!
I have a reason for hating Morgana. Why do you wish her dead?
We fairies have long memories. She slew our leader, Glam, many centuries ago.
Farewell, fairies. I will return soon. Human hair. It's black and silky. It must be Morgana's.
Now, how did her hair get up there? I never even seen Morgana's hair. She always has her head covered.
A human hair.
Tell me what you think of me, Knight. Am I not more beautiful than that one foolish creature who makes a fool of my half-brother, Arthur?
Well, you do look like a sexy version of the Wicked Witch of the West, and I hear you give good head. But Lady Guinevere is a crazy sex addict, so I would have to go with her.
You have great beauty, Morgana. But your heart is evil.
Poor fool! You understand nothing. Merlin has been filling your head with false ideas about morality. There is no morality. There is no good or evil. These are purely the ideals of Arthur's new religion. I will not say.
Hello everyone. I am the PlayGamer3. This is part 19 of my walkthrough of Chronicles of the Sword.
We meet again. Not quite so successful at evading me without that old fool Merlin to hold your hand. Your name is? It slipped my mind. Are you a messenger or an assassin? Well, have you been struck dumb? What, Arthur, wicked and evil? But tell me, how does it feel to be a cockroach about to be stamped on?
No, but killing a priest, killing Helly, trying to destroy Camelot, that makes you an evil bitch.
You may kill me, but others will come to find me.
Enough of this! You are an assassin sent by Merlin, now you will die!
You will die also, Morgana.
Goodbye. What have you got to say for yourself?
Let me go and we can just forget about everything that went on between us.
Morgana, I have a message from the king.
Have you ever wondered, Knight, why you were sent here to face me? You mean nothing to me. You are just a scrap of life, waiting to be stepped on and snuffed
out. I'm sure Merlin and King Arthur will save me. They will send an army to come rescue me. Oh. Who am I kidding? They're not going to come save me.
I am a knight of the greatest court in Albion. I have sworn allegiance to my king and queen, and I am sworn to fight to the death any living thing which threatens their safety.
I will serve neither Arthur nor a false divinity, as you can see. I am a much misunderstood woman. Poor Helly. Such a simple creature.
Helly was loyal to you until you betrayed her.
Death comes to you. If I stamp on a cockroach, does that make me evil? If I snuff out an obstacle, does that make me wicked? Arthur has slaughtered whole armies in the furtherance of his ambitions. Does that make